Okay, so we are continuing modeling, and right now I'm going to do this part where we can attach our grip. So again, very simple poly modeling. We are just extruding edges and cutting them, creating this round shape. So you can see I constantly look on the references just to make sure that we are doing the right thing. And of course, you can see we have to close this front and back area. So I've extruded this edge. And right now we adjust some of the vertices and then we will be closing this area. Using probably a pen tool. So you can see I've cloned this front part and attached it to the back just to save time. And that's it almost. We have to just mirror it and I will merge it to have one solid piece of geometry. You can see I've added these additional holes. And right now we are moving to the another part of the weapon, In here we are starting with a simple box and we are extruding and cutting it. And this way we will develop shape a little bit more. So in this case it's really box modeling. I am using now bevel tool to make this edge a little bit rounder. And now we are expanding our mesh and we are working on this area around the trigger. Okay, so we are moving forward. I will be trying to close this trigger area. So I'm always checking everything from every possible direction if there is any problem. I'm always very concerned about the edges because sometimes I see models that have too hard edges and it looks just like a fake, like a toys, for example, like a toy. So you really want to be picky about this. If the edge is a little bit round, it should be made this way.